right, Andy Rovat, 2008 Olympian, former MIT. How many times did you win this tournament?
Once.
Really?
Senior year? I think we wrestled twice, maybe. Maybe
really?
Once.
Okay. What's new with Silent H? First off, show him that comb over. Get down there and let him see that. He's rocking the comb over. He's got the beard going. But Andy, let's talk. What's been going on with the Silent H? What are you up to? How's Colorado?
I moved to Colorado in June, and right before our camps. We had camp all summer, and then after camp, I went with the number ones, number twos, went to the Worlds. We had a camp in Germany. By ourselves in a small village, and then we went to the Worlds, and then after the Worlds I went by myself to Russia for a month. I had no translator, nobody spoke English. I wrestled in two tournaments. I wrestled one in Yakutsk, I was third, and then 2 weeks later I went to Chechnya, which I don't think I was supposed to go there, but I was there.
Were you in Grozny?
Yeah, I was in Grozny, probably one of the roughest places in the world,
and that's like almost like the Iowa of the Soviet Union. It's kind of like they're backwoods dudes that are pretty tough, right? Satyevs are from Chechnya, right?
Yeah. Chechnya has a lot of good wrestlers. That whole area,
Dagestan.
It's like probably smaller than Ohio, and like Chechnya, Dagestan, and Ossetia are all within an hour and a half drive of each other. But so I was down there. I was training in Vladikavkaz, where I was last January. And you know, at my weight class there, they have Gitsalov, who's a four-time world champ, Olympic champ. They have Katoyev, who's a world champ. They have Tagiev, who was 96, second in the Olympics. They have the guy who was fifth in the Olympics, Georgi Dubilov. They have the 2008 junior world champ. They have, they have a couple more guys.
All 96 kilos.
All 96 kilos. They have good heavyweights, good 84 kilos. So they have Kisoyev, who was a European champ last year at 84 kilos. They have the guy at 84 kilos who beat me at the Worlds that trains there. He wrestles for Armenia. He was my host last time I was there. He drove me around, took really good care of me.
The guy you had to wrestle in the World Championships was your host.
Yeah.
Is that weird?
No, it wasn't weird. I've talked to him after that and before. Actually, before I wrestled him in the World Championships, we had a dual meet in Yakutsk in 2004. And I was the only 84 kilo there, and they brought him and Sajidov to wrestle me. And after the match, I was sponsored by Adidas at the time, and I had two pairs of Adidas shoes with me, and he wanted one, so I didn't really care. I was like, I'll just get a new pair when I get home, you know, they're free. So I gave him my shoes, and he ended up coming back, giving me a Russian wrestling warm-up, and I think he actually beat me in the Worlds with the shoes I gave him. I think. I'm not positive.
That would be that's irony.
Yeah, that's pretty bad. Whatever. I mean.
Okay, Eagles. Let's talk St. Edward Eagles, okay? St. Ed's Eagles, third at the Ironman. Nice showing there. They're without their top dog, Jamie Clark. Talk St. Ed's, you know, the pride you have in being a St. Edward Eagle.
I love St. Ed's. I mean, if it wasn't for them, I wouldn't be where I'm at today. They really prepared me, you know, how to become a wrestler. And, you know, Coach Irwin, Coach Hoff, and Coach Leonard, you know, they're such great coaches. And, you know, Hoff is really smart when it comes to, you know, letting people be individuals and not just in the system. You know, if you want to wrestle a certain way, he'll let you. And, you know, he'll make sure you get the best out of, you know, what you like to do. And,
you got any more?
No,
is that it with all of them?
I guess.
That's all you want to say about St. Ed's?
Yeah, I mean, it's just great to be a part of it. I mean, it's fun to watch them, and the fact that they're still going strong after, you know,
78 32 years. Brian Heffernan's first champ. 78.
Like 32 years ago.
Crazy. Okay, new shirts. I want to show them new shirts real quick.
I don't feel able to see it.
Oh, yeah, we got it. And what's going on with this, Andy? Talk about the shirt real quick.
I designed it last summer. I had another color, but I wanted to get white with real light gray so you can't see it. Make it real
definitely. It's kind of.
It's real soft.
Yeah, I like that. It's a good one.
A lot of girls like it.
You get a lot of those.
Yeah, so I make a lot of small sizes for them.
All right, talk about the transition now from Ann Arbor, Michigan, Zeeb Road, where you used to live, to Colorado Springs.
The transition it's been hard because, I mean, I did it when I was older. I'm 29. And, you know, maybe when I was 22 to 24, I was able to train 2 times a day every day. But now that I'm getting older, I have to sit down with my coaches and talk to them a little bit about how my body feels and, you know, just to be more smart about training and, you know, developing.
Watch the pounding, basically.
Yeah, you know, I can't just go in there and beat my body up twice a day. You know, I've been getting hurt this year, and I think it's because of that. And, you know, being able to train smart is going to help me a lot, and it's going to help me. I mean, you can train easy and not kill yourself, but really start developing a lot of skills. So that's what I'm hoping to do. And, you know, I like Colorado a lot, but, you know, I'm there a lot, but it's not all the time. You know, I was in Russia a month. I'm going back for about 2 months at the end of January to go train, just no tournaments, just training.
How often did you say Spicy Bell?
Say what?
Spicy Bell.
Spicy Bell. That's all I knew.
Pajalsta?
Yeah.
That's please and you're welcome. You know that, right? Pajalsta?
Pajalsta, you're welcome.
Yeah, but and please. Both. Dual meetings. All right. Last thing, how cool is it to be home with your family for the holidays here in the Cleveland area?
It's nice. I haven't been home in a year since last Christmas because I was traveling so much last year. And then after I moved to Colorado, so I wasn't able to get home in the summer because of camps. But it's nice to be home and then, you know, to be here and then to know I'm coming back for the U.S. Open is really nice. You know, that I really think it's going to be a good event, even though some people aren't happy about it. But I think being in Cleveland and you know, and me being probably the only person who's going to be there that was actually born and lived in the city of Cleveland.
Literally Cleveland, too. Not outskirts.
Not a suburb.
Not a suburb.
The city.
All right, we've got Parade of Champions. We're going to sit and watch this, and you can do some commentating with me. So let's get to it, all right?
All right.